Hey there, my name is Charles, and this is part two of a series in which I'm using Unity to recreate the core system from Red Dead Redemption 2. In part one, we started off by creating a fully functional UI to display the health core. In this video, we'll be bringing that UI to life by implementing health regeneration. If you haven't already, I highly recommend watching part one so it's easier to follow along. Otherwise, let's get right into it. Just like last time, let's begin by reviewing the user story that we're going to work on. As a player who wants to focus on combat, I want Arthur's health ring to regenerate based on the value of his health core so he can survive longer without using consumables. Now, that seems pretty self-explanatory, but we've also got some acceptance criteria and notes that'll guide us once we get to work. Given that his health core is full, Arthur's health ring should regenerate at maximum efficiency. With half a health core, its regeneration rate should be halved. And, given that his health core is empty, Arthur's health should not regenerate at all. The regeneration rate should be tunable, and the health ring should not regenerate past its capacity. This information is designed to answer any questions that may arise during development. And you'll notice that all of the wording is focused on the functionality and behavior that we'll be adding to the project, rather than the implementation details. This is an important part of the Scrum methodology. How this behavior gets implemented is up to us, the developers, after we do some technical planning. But that's outside of the scope of this video. I've already done some basic whiteboarding and have a pretty decent idea of how I'm going to implement this. But if you're interested in learning more about the process I'm using here, which is called Scrum, then let me know in the comments. I got some great feedback in part one, and I'd love to hear more about what the community would like to see in the future. In the meantime, let's go ahead and get to work on this user story. First things first, we're definitely going to need a script to drive this behavior. So let's create a mono behavior called health system. And add it to the root game object of the health core UI. Then open it up in your code editor. Now, to be honest, I'm not 100% sure how this code is going to look. But I know from my whiteboarding session that we'll at least need to expose the following fields: a float value for the ring value, the ring capacity, and the core value, and a float for the regeneration rate. I also know that all of the work is going to happen in the update method, so let's implement that as well. By the way, I implemented that update method using a feature of the code editor that I use, which is called Writer. A lot of you have commented on it, and I just thought I'd take a moment to say that Writer is an amazing tool, and I highly recommend it. I'll leave a link in the description if you're interested in checking it out. Now, again, I'm not exactly sure how I'm going to write this. And when that's the case, I usually use test-driven development to tease out an implementation. So let's create a test class called Health System Tests, and add a base case. For our user story, the base case is that when Arthur's health core is empty, his health ring doesn't regenerate. So let's create a test method called emptyCore_noRegeneration. I'm using a naming convention that places the starting state on the left of an underscore, and the resulting, or expected, state on the right. Now, since our code will live in the update method, we'll need to make this a Unity test by marking it with the Unity test attribute and having it return an IEnumerator. Yielding to null ensures that just a single update is called. Now we can instantiate an instance of health system and initialize all of its fields. Being that this is the base case, we should set the core and ring values to 0, and the ring capacity and regeneration rate to 1. Lastly, we just need to add an assertion. Let's assert that after one update has elapsed, the ring value is still equal to 0. And we'll pass in float's epsilon value as the delta. This is just something we have to do when working with floating point values. All right. Now we can run our first test, and it passes, but that doesn't mean we're ready to move on. We haven't written any actual logic. we need to introduce something that implements the actual behavior. So let's switch back to the health system class and add a simple guard clause to the update method. If the health core's value equals 0, then return. Now we can rerun the test. And it still passes. But Ryder is warning me about this comparison. Again, we're dealing with float values, so we'll need to add a more sophisticated comparison that takes a delta into account. Okay, we've refactored the code, so let's rerun the test one more time. Beautiful. Let's switch back to the health system test class and tease out some more of this algorithm. We know that if the health core is full, then the health ring should regenerate at full efficiency. So let's create a test called full core underscore max regeneration rate. And we can just copy and paste the logic from our base case test. Except, we'll need to adjust these values. The core value should be equal to 1 this time. And after one update call, we would expect that the health ring's value should be equal to delta time. So let's update the assert as well. This is because the regeneration rate is set to 1 per second, and delta time represents how much time, in seconds, has elapsed since the previous frame. Let's run the test. And it failed. Which is what you'd expect when doing test-driven development. See, a failing test is the first step in the red-green refactor cycle. If you'd like to learn more about test-driven development, then you should check out my series called TDD in Unity. It walks through the entire process of test-driven development with a practical example, and provides some tips for doing TDD specifically in Unity. Let's get this test to pass by adding some logic to the health system class. Starting simple, I know we can go green if we set the ring value to delta time, but that's obviously not the right algorithm. Delta time is a good start, but we aren't factoring in the core value or the regeneration rate, so why don't we go ahead and include those in the calculation? Alright, looking good. But we're setting the ring to the same value every update. We need to be adding the value instead. Much better. Let's run the test. Beautiful. Let's switch back to the test class and tease out some more functionality following the same process. The health system needs to stop regeneration once Arthur's health reaches its capacity. So let's add a test called full health underscore no regeneration. Again, copy the code from the previous test. And go ahead and max out all of the values. And assert that the ring value is equal to 1. I say max out because, like image's fill value, our core and ring values are going to range from 0 to 1. Now, we'll need to add some more sophisticated tooling and checks to our code for that eventually. But that work falls outside of the scope of this user story, so we won't worry about that right now. In any case, let's test and watch it go red. Perfect. Let's switch back to the health system class and introduce another guard clause that returns when the health ring value is equal to its capacity. Great, the test passes. But Ryder is warning me about this float comparison, so we can just do another quick refactor. And the test stays green. I think it's time to take this bad boy for a spin. Switch back to Unity and make sure that the value of the health core is set to 1, health capacity is 0.5, and health ring is 0. Now, run the scene. Uh-oh. What happened there? It shouldn't have regenerated past the halfway point. I think we're going to need to gather some more information to debug this. So, let's switch back to the code editor and write the new value to the console. That way, we'll know exactly what's happening during each frame. Perfect. Now, switch back to Unity, reset the values, and run the scene again. Let's examine the logs. Aha, check it out. Our guard clause only returns when the health ring value is equal to its capacity. But, according to the log, that never happens. We're going to need to fix the algorithm, so let's switch back to the code editor and write a new test. This time, we'll name our test almostfull_regenerates_to_full. You see, we're going to need to handle the case where the next tick of update would cause the health ring to overfill. So let's copy the code from the previous test and set the health ring value to 0.999. And, of course, it fails, which is exactly what we need to drive us forward. So back in the health system class, we'll need to make sure that we're never overshooting the ring's capacity. And one way to do that is by calling math.min and passing in both the capacity and our new value. We run the test. Nice. And a quick spot check in Unity. Beautiful. And with that, I think we can officially call this user story complete. If you're interested in grabbing the code, then head on over to my Patreon page, where you can download it free of charge. And as a bonus to my Tier 2 patrons, I've gone ahead and refactored the unit tests to remove some of that duplication. If you're interested in checking that bonus code out, please consider becoming a patron today. I'll have a link to both in the description. All right, that's it for part 2. In part 3, we'll keep this momentum going and knock out the last bit of the health system's main functionality. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a comment letting me know what you thought. And for more Unity videos and tutorials just like this one, don't forget to subscribe, notifications on. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Thank you to all of my patrons, and a special shout out to NZ, Richard Stance, Sean Carey, Thomas, Willendingo, and Yagov.